when studying images, of images, it's always good to use the powers of the eyes to know what kind of image is being represented by another image. When one lays another image on an image, what kind of image is needed, what kind of image is being represented by the other image. And that's why I normally use the powers of the eyes, because the powers of the eyes, you can say so much, you can speak so much, but if you don't have a particular image or a particular background, it doesn't help, because nobody believes you that image belongs to you. And I normally use things like spectacles, and I normally use things like spectacles to study that image, to know what kind of image I'm presenting, or in what kind of image is being presented by my image. And I use a lot of objects in the background, a lot of objects in the background to fully cover my image, and so that any other impressions that are made by my background can be studied and cataloged and publicized as they are presented to my viewers, so that when sitting in front of a camera and sitting in front of viewers, it is always good to consider the powers of the eyes, because the eyes are very, very powerful medical weapons. The eyes are very, very, very powerful programmers. They can program any background, they can program any image, they can remove any other images from an image, and they can be used to represent a person as one appears as an individual. They can be used to sort out individuals, so that one particular individual is represented by the background and by the image and by the entity that represents one person. So that I always use the background and my eyes to study the background. And I use a lot of pictures beside my pictures when speaking, so that those voices are also taken and recorded, so that when I arrive as one voice and not as a mob, not as a hub, not as a conclusion of artwork, not as a failed artwork, not as a work, an unfulfilled work of art, not an unfulfilled work of science. So that the eyes that I normally talk to, the people that I normally talk to, I use a lot of the eyes to dissipate all illusions or dissipate all disillusionment, that I do the work of other people. And that's why it is always good to use the background, to always choose the background of the images or of the people behind me to represent me and to represent my image too. And that is why when I represent female images, I can use spectacles. For example, like I'm using these spectacles to study the image, the emancipated image that I'm giving to my viewers, so that when they study it, they are pleased by the effects and by of the work and of the image and of the representation of their thoughts as souls, as clean souls, which love themselves and love the environment, and love me, and love my environment, and would like to see me, and would like to see more of my own image. So that when I say, for example, that I am, when I'm talking about myself, I'm not talking about God, because God spoke on all this stuff that is behind me. When I talk about it, I'm talking about this stuff that does not belong to, for example, the television, I'll say that it belongs to me. And I use such images, for example, like a television, for example, if I can sit on the television again, that helps people feel comfortable and feel able to feel comfortable and responsible and are able to follow and sit on my seats and take a replace me on the seats and sit beside, sit in front of me. And that is, for example, a SIM card, it is called a microchip that I'm using for.